Let's go to the library.
I'll call to order the Wyoming City Council meeting of Tuesday, September 5, 2023, one of our unusual Tuesday night meetings that we have occasionally. Hope everybody had a great weekend with Labor Day yesterday. Our opening invocation tonight will be given by Heather Dode from Grace Reformed Church. If you wish and are able, please stand for the invocation. The Pledge of Allegiance will immediately follow the invocation.
Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you that we have come here tonight to discuss the business of the city. Lord, I just pray for these officials that are here tonight. Lord, I just pray for grace and mercy and wisdom and discernment on this spot. Lord, I also pray for our city. Lord, I pray for the chaos to cease, that there is no division and unity. Lord, we just ask so boldly that you continue to help us to be your hands and feet in the city. Help us to do the ways that you wish. Lord, just continue to ask for grace through many situations and concerns that may be before you tonight. Lord, we just ask for conversations that are one that are honoring to you as well, and just the benefit of the doubt of all parties involved. Lord, just continue to let your spirit feed your tonight as your guide and listen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. A roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilmember Arnoyes.
Here.
Brand.
Present.
DeKreiger.
Here.
Hill.
Here.
Postma.
Here.
Postler.
Here.
Mayor.
Here. Student recognition. Early in the school year, but you never know. We may have an anxious student who wants to get that high school credit, extra credit, or whatever it might be out of the way. I don't see any of those. So, approval of minutes. You were sent the minutes from the August 21st, 2023 regular meeting. Those will stand approved as submitted unless there's objection. Seeing none, those minutes are approved. Approval of agenda. Mr. Shea, anything to add tonight?
No.
No additions. I take a motion for approval of agenda. Moved by Postler, support by Postman. Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Postler.
Yes.
Postma.
Yes.
Arnoyes.
Yes.
Brand.
Yes.
DeKreiger.
Yes.
Hill.
Yes.
Mayor.
Yes. No public hearings tonight, so we'll move to public comment on agenda items. This public comment period is reserved for comment on agenda items only. If you wish to speak about an item that is not on the agenda, please hold your comments until the acknowledgement of visitors section at the end of the meeting. It is important to note this is not an opportunity for dialogue or debate. This is an opportunity to provide comment to the City Council. Upon approaching the podium, please begin by providing your name and address. There's a 3-minute limit per person. Anyone wish to speak to the agenda tonight? Okay, seeing none. We have no presentations or proclamations. We have no petitions or communications. We have no reports from city officers. We have no budget amendments. Consent agenda. I'll take a motion for that. Moved by DeKreiger. Support by Postler. Call the roll, please.
Councilmember DeKreiger.
Yes.
Postler.
Yes.
Arnoyes.
Yes.
Brand.
Yes.
Hill.
Yes.
Postma.
Yes.
Mayor.
Yes. Resolution B, please.
Resolution B is to establish the polling place for Precinct 16 and Precinct 17 in the city of Wyoming, Kent County, Michigan.
Motion. DeKreiger. Support by Hill. Kelly, could you just give us a little brief update on that since that's under your department?
Absolutely. So we have 30 precincts in the city of Wyoming, and we house them in about 21 locations throughout the city. On occasion, we have a facility that no longer quite fits our needs, and that was the case in this scenario. We were attempting to enter a facilities use agreement with one of our current locations, and we found that some of the requests we were receiving just would not work logistically with our elections operations. So we explored a new location, and we have commitment from them. And with council's approval tonight, we can then take the necessary steps to notify voters of this change.
Great. Any discussion or questions for Kelly? Okay, let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Postuma?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Award of bids, contracts, purchases, and renewal of bids and contracts. Letter C, please.
Resolution C is to concur with entering into an agreement for an emergency cybersecurity incident response.
Motion, please. Motion by Postuma, support by Postler. Mr. Shea, go ahead.
So we had a cybersecurity incident where there was an attack on our network, an attempted ransomware attack. And we received our systems detected it, and our IT department did a fabulous job of immediately responding to the situation and limiting it to the area of intrusion. So there was no theft of data or taking over our systems or anything like that. Out of an abundance of caution, I did authorize hiring Sentinel Technologies after IT did their initial triage and response, authorized Sentinel Technologies to determine if any data was breached or if any other computers were affected over a weekend period, just to be safe. They did not detect anything. And the bill before you is the cost for Sentinel Technologies to do that round-the-clock monitoring of our system. We just wanted to make sure there was no loss of data, there was no compromise of any of our operations or anything like that. So that's what that bill is for.
Good. Any questions? I just would like to say this is really, really important. We do have Todd here tonight, too, if you want more detail than what John gave. But it's a friend of mine just discovered last week, I think Thursday, that he had $29,000 taken out of his account. He's still fighting. He's filing sheriff's reports. He lives up north. He got duped. He got hacked somehow, and this stuff happens. I'm guessing this is a new measure we're taking on top of what we've already been doing, right? Because, I mean, we do this already.
Yeah, we IT
did it. It's just like added layer?
Yeah, this was out of an abundance of caution. IT keeps all of our systems up to date. They do testing, so they want to test employees to make sure they don't click on links that they're not supposed to. We do up-to-date software and hardware updates. And I can say with this, IT reacted literally within minutes and really limited the scope of this intrusion to just one small area. So really hats off to them for this. And but we just felt, just to be super safe, we wanted to hire Sentinel to really make sure that there were no other vulnerabilities or any data that was breached or anything like that. So
thanks, guys. Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Postuma?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Let's take D and E together.
Resolution D is to purchase canines, to accept donations for the purchase, and to express appreciation for the donations. This resolution includes budget amendment number 24. And resolution E is to authorize the purchase and licensing of tasers.
Motion, please. By Hill, support by Arnoyes. Do you want to give a couple comment, or do you want to?
Yeah, we had a couple of our canine units retire, and we along with many other agencies, use Shallow Creek Kennels that provide the dogs. And we selected two dogs to replace the two dogs that retired. With both dogs, one dog would be covered up front by the, I think it's the K9 Foundation, K911 Foundation. And then the other dog would be covered by the Weller Foundation. Their board doesn't meet till the end of this month. We would have to front the cost of that, but we expect to be reimbursed by that as well. And this would allow us to purchase two K9 units and have it fully funded by other foundations.
So Bane and Radar.
I think Radar was initially, but didn't pass his physical. So I think it's Bane and Scout.
Bane and Scout. Oh, wow. Okay.
Poor Radar.
Yeah.
Who chooses the names?
Yeah.
The handler, okay. Once we get possession of them, we name the dog. Okay, they're not during the, okay, good. Well, welcome, Maine and Scout, if we pass this tonight, so let's call the roll.
Well, the resolution was on two resolutions, so the other one was to purchase 10 tasers, their holsters, the battery pack, the licensing agreement, docking stations, for a cost of $27,600 over a five-year period of time. This would match up our contract. We have a contract with Axon to purchase body cameras and tasers. Right now, we just need tasers for some of the new officers and also to replace some of the ones that have broken. And this will get us through the next 5 years for those tasers.
Okay. Any questions? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Hill.
Yes.
Arnoyes.
Yes.
Brand.
Yes.
DeKreiger.
Yes.
Postuma.
Yes.
Hostler.
Yes.
Mayor.
Yes. Letter F, please.
Resolution F is to accept an agreement from National Hose Testing Specialties, Inc. for testing and certification of the city fire hoses, ladders, and aerial devices.
Motion, please. DeKreiger. Support by Brand. Well, give us a little heads up.
Yeah, so this is the NFPA, or the National Fire Protection Association, does require annual testing of our hoses, ladders, and aerial equipment. And so we reached out to three companies to do that. One didn't even respond back to us. One of them didn't do the aerial testing, and the one we selected does test the hoses, the ladders, and the aerial equipment. And so the cost would be just under $12,600. We did look at, since we have to do this every year, could we enter into a multi-year agreement with them? But they were hesitant to do that because they weren't sure how much the price could change in future years. So this is for a 1 year.
Thank you for checking into that, because that was a question I had as well. Any questions for John on that? Got to keep our hoses good.
Yeah, I could have swore I thought it was a multi-year one, too, looking at.
That was, no, the tasers is over 5 years.
Tasers was the five-year.
And we approved a multi-year.
Well, but not the hoses.
But not the, the hoses
not
would
the
be.
Not the testing?
Yeah, that would be annual.
Yeah.
Five-year testing.
There's certain annual equipment, depending on what it is, could be tested once every 5 years, but the hoses and ladders and the aerials are annual testing.
Oh, okay, one.
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay. Good.
Thanks for that clarity.
Good eyes, though.
Well, I know. I saw it.
Yeah.
It's like, wait a minute.
Well, and we have approved a couple of multi-year contracts in the last couple of meetings, so it's kind of still in our mind. Let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger.
Yes.
Brand.
Yes.
Arnoyes.
Yes.
Hill.
Yes.
Postuma.
Yes.
Hostler.
Yes.
Mayor.
Yes. Let's do award of bids, letter G, please.
Resolution G is to award a bid for the building addition and renovation project for fire stations.
Motion, please. Motion by Brand and support by Marissa. This is one we've been waiting on. So you all saw in the letter last week from John, the description of it with the budget, and also in the materials that came out prior to the meeting. But you want to just give us a run through so we're really, really clear where the dollars are coming from?
Yep. So this is to renovate the Division and Burton fire stations. And when we talk about that, we're talking about new and updated kitchens, new appliances, new locker rooms with restrooms, and new bedrooms as well. And so the bids came in. We went out to bid. I believe there were four bidders, and the lowest bid came in from JWK Construction for $1,981,000. We're recommending that we also add $300,000, just over $300,000 in for certain contingencies. So there'll be some construction engineering. There may have to be some additional excavation at the Division site because there was an old garage that was improperly removed, decades ago. So we may have to deal with that. And also some furnishings as well. So how we would pay for this, we're looking at a total cost of about $2,281,000. And we had budgeted with ARPA funds about $1.6 million. We've spent some of that obviously on the engineering for this project. And so how we would pay for that is about $1,455,000 from the ARPA funds allocated for this project. And then we also had some unobligated ARPA funds of just almost $400,000. And then we also had ARPA funds currently allocated to the treasurer's drive-through project. And so what we're looking to do is to pay for the renovations to the two fire stations, all with really ARPA funds that were allocated to this project, unobligated ARPA funds, and also transferring the ARPA funds from the treasurer's drive-through project to this project. So this project would be paid for with the ARPA funds. Now, having said that, we still have an issue with the drive-through situation with the treasurer's office. And I know that the council had originally authorized using ARPA funds to pay for that project. We came with a low bid a couple months ago. I don't remember exact date. And council said, let's take another look at that. So we are looking at both a short-term and long-term solution to that that we hope and expect would be less than what we brought to you. But if, when we bring that to you, we'd have to look at using fund balance to pay for that because we wouldn't have any ARPA funds available if ARPA funds are used for this project. Our treasurer is here, and Tracy, I just wanted to know if you could come up and just sort of explain the need also for the drive-through project, because I think just last week was the deadline to pay taxes, so it was quite busy in the last couple
of years. I got your numbers, too.
Okay. I did email an example of
Is that on?
Turn the mic on at the bottom, the base. There you go.
Can you hear me now?
Yep.
I did email you a video that clearly demonstrates, thank you, the issues that we're dealing with. We have had challenges with the drive up for a long time, which is why the council had dedicated those ARPA funds to this issue. Immediate needs are the drive up. The drawer does not work. It's broken. So we hope to get that fixed soon. But in the long term, I think you'll see with the traffic, the volume and the traffic issues that we have, the way the drive is constructed, we have people waiting in line and turning away because of the line that we have. We have issues where they can't, almost every customer cannot reach the drawer, so they end up getting out of the car. I have concerns for safety in that regard. It's quite often snowy and icy. We do our public works department does a great job of keeping that clear and salted, but we do have concerns. People leave their car in drive and open the door and step out and the car starts moving. That happens a lot. And just this week, you know, we had a woman drop her cash under the car. It happens quite often. So I would just ask that you take all of those things into consideration when dedicating any funds to fixing the issue. I think if we're planning long term, if we're doing it right, we need to dedicate the funds to correct the problems that we're having there.
So I just bring that up just for purposes of the fire stations that we're proposing to use all ARPA funds, including the ARPA funds that were originally dedicated to the drive-through project. And I just wanted to emphasize that the issues with the drive-through have not gone away. Facilities and the treasurer's office have met, and we're coming up with both a short-term and long-term recommendations for that. But I just wanted to let the council know that, you know, we would be coming back at a later date with some recommendations on how to address that particular issue.
And I'll just add, the reason our city manager is stressing that is because I asked him to, because we met last week, and when we made the decision to shift gears and go this route, I also want to go on record to say that in voting on this resolution tonight or this bid tonight, we are taking money that we had allocated from our ARPA funds way back last summer, last fall. So by taking that and putting it toward the fire station needs, we're fixing one problem at the expense of another real issue and problem. So I do expect we will be coming back. And the other advantage of waiting is by the time we look at this in a general fund transfer sort of way, probably we'll have a little bit better idea of where we end the year. Our fiscal year two, hopefully. So it'll put us in a position of clearly knowing where we're at with fund balance.
Sure. That's correct.
Yeah. So if you vote for it tonight, make sure you know that that doesn't end the discussion on the canopy. Any questions?
What time do we vote for what though? The right now we're voting for the fire.
That's correct. Just for the fire station renovation. Okay. Has nothing. There's no vote tonight on the drive-through project.
Okay, I'm just, all I ask is to watch our taxpayers' money and not try and be a martyr here, but I just wonder, just bring back something a little bit lower, you know, or a lot lower, and then maybe fix what we have to fix. And I just don't know if we need that canopy. And
we're looking at trying to come back with hopefully something significantly lower cost that meets the needs of the residents that use that drive through. Okay. So that's our intent. And again, we're looking at, and there's some short term needs that we got to deal with right away. But there may also be some, as Tracy mentioned, some long-term needs to look at as the popularity of that drive-through increases each year. But that's our intent.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Arnoyce?
So back to the fire station piece, how's the staff feel as far as the fire staff? Are they feeling this is a great solution? The enhancements are going to be a great improvement? Any commentary on the feedback that we've gotten from the firefighters?
Facilities has worked with representatives from the fire department on the planning of these renovations. So, and I don't know if we've picked out every little furnishing, and I know we'll have their input on that kind of stuff as well. But I think this has been viewed very positively and much needed renovations for both. If you've been through there, you know, those facilities look pretty tired, mm-hmm. To put it charitably, and this will go a long ways towards really fixing that.
Good. I think we're all ready. We want to see it get started as soon as possible. When will that be?
From what we understand, they could start later this month, and we would expect construction to go through at least May of next year.
Okay. Any more questions? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Brand?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Arnoyce?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postuma?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Let's do letter H, please.
Resolution H is to approve change order number 1 for the Public Works Salt Dome Conveyor Project. This resolution includes budget amendment number 23.
Motion, please. Postuma. Support by Arnoyce.
So if you recall back in July, this conveyor, when they dump salt off at our public works, we use front end loaders and put this on a conveyor, and the conveyor conveys the salt up into our salt storage building. That conveyor had broken. The council agreed to get it fixed, and the contractor that is fixing it discovered additional damage to that conveyor. I think it was roughly just over $7,800 in additional damage. So we're recommending that the council approve that change order to allow that work to be completed. We obviously do need this conveyor in working. I know it's 90 whatever degrees outside, but we will be needing it probably in the not too distant future.
Questions?
Do we know the company that originally built the conveyor and the conveyor line and all that? Because we have a couple of them here in Grand Rapids that do that type of work. I was just curious.
I know we went out for bids on this project and we selected the low bidder. And I think even with this particular change order, we'd still be almost $24,000, $25,000 less than what the next lowest bid was.
Wow.
So,
okay.
Yeah. So that's what we did. Seek those proposals in order, and we just chose the lowest. I think it was the lowest one.
Okay. So. Yeah. Now, did we use I know Dematic builds conveyor lines are here in Grand Rapids and some of the other companies. I just didn't know if it was a local company originally.
This is a local company. It's actually a sheet metal fabricator company, and they specialize in oddball repairs like this one.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it is cool.
That is cool. Thank you.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Postuma?
Yes.
Arnoyce?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Letter J, please.
I.
You know, sometimes when I look at that I, it looks like a J without a hook on the bottom. So I've done that twice now. I called I, J. Let's do I.
Team sport.
Yeah, team sport.
Okay. Resolution I is to authorize the purchase of vehicles and equipment.
Let's get a motion, please. Motion by Postma, second by Postler. And by the way, I'm getting my eyes checked in 2 weeks. It's my end.
Okay.
Got a motion? Second? Questions?
This is really just to purchase 3 trucks. One's a Ford F-550 with a utility box, and then the others are F-250s, 4-wheel drives with plows on them. The total cost, including all the upfitting with all of that equipment, is $176,000. And these vehicles have finally become available. We budgeted for them quite a while ago, but they finally now became available.
Questions? Call the roll.
Councilmember Postma?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Now we'll do letter J.
Resolution J is to authorize M&M Pavement Marking to perform the annual pavement markings for 2023.
Motion, please. DeKreiger, support.
So we...
By Postma.
Oh.
I gotta get it.
So the Kent County Road Commission bid this out last year. And so we used those bid prices last year. And the contractor, M&M Pavement Marking, has agreed to extend those prices from last year to this year. So we're recommending that we go with that bid from M&M Pavement Marking. And we do our striping of our major streets, and we expect to spend about $58,000 for this work. It's something we do every year.
Yeah. And I did ask John about this last week, if, you know, we could do bids or get it lower and all this, but we have to realize that we're part of a countywide bid, and this is basically our portion, and this is what we're obligated to as part of the whole big effort, correct?
I think they bid unit prices, and then we just have to multiply that by the quantities of how much roads we have.
So this is Wyoming's portion.
Yep. Of that. So.
Questions? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Postma?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Letter K, please.
Resolution K is to concur with the emergency repair of a 36-inch storm sewer. This resolution includes budget amendment number 22.
Motion, please. Postler, support by Hill. John, want to talk to folks?
Yeah, this is an annoying one, at least to me.
That's a pretty picture of the whole.
We just repaved Eastern Avenue, and then a sinkhole developed back in July, and discovered that there was a 36-inch steel storm sewer pipe, privately owned. It wasn't a public storm sewer, that was failing to the point where sand and gravel was infiltrating into it and caused the sinkhole to develop. So we reached out to 3 contractors to do a cured in place pump pipelining. They can line the inside of the pipe, and went with Waste Recovery Systems for about $85,000. And then we're looking at seeing if we can be reimbursed. Myron, I'm not sure who the owner is, but we're looking at who the owner is and seeking reimbursement for that. So,
what did that cost? I knew that wasn't mine. Yeah, I couldn't see
sorry.
You. Did you have a question for Myron? No.
No.
Okay. Any questions for John?
Yeah.
John,
Dominic? What's the chances that you think we'll get reimbursed? I mean,
want me to take this girl?
I do.
I think I'm really good, because if they don't voluntarily do it, we'll single out assessment.
Yeah.
Great.
We amended the ordinance a while ago to be able to do that, so we're pretty sure we know the responsible party or parties, and we will do what we need to. We're talking with the owner to try to get it worked out. If we can't, we'll be back with a resolution to start a special assessment procedure to get reimbursed.
It's good news.
Yeah.
Call the roll.
Councilmember Postler?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Postma?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. We'll take the next 4, LMNO, all public works related issues all at once, please.
Resolution L is to authorize the purchase of hydrofluorosilic acid. almost had it, to purchase a pulsifeeder pump. Resolution N is to accept a proposal for the confined space safety upgrades at the clean water plant. And resolution O is to accept a quotation for repair of one pump at the water treatment plant.
Motion by Postma, support by Arnold. Discussion, questions, John or Myron? None? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Postma?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
No.
Postler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Letter P, please.
Resolution P is for award of bids of masonry restoration.
The building's set on again. Oh, motion first. Motion. DeKreiger, support. Hill. Okay, I could jump my gun there, but yeah, forgot what building that's on. I saw it.
Yeah, no, this is just masonry repairs at the clean water plant.
Yeah.
And some of the brick facades go back to the 60s and 70s. We received three bids, and we're recommending acceptance of a low bid from Kent Companies. So I think that's about really it.
Any questions? Routine maintenance. Call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Postma?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Ordinance 10-23, please.
Ordinance 10-23 is to amend Section 90-515 of the Code of Ordinances by adding subsection 139 to rezone 804 and 810 Chemist Street Southwest from B1 local business to R2 residential. This ordinance is in final reading.
Motion, please. DeKreiger. Support by Postler. Marissa's making up for lost time. I love that. The gun is similar. Questions?
I need to declare a conflict of interest. This is the same issue we had a month ago, but the applicant here is a client of mine. So.
Oh, okay. We have to vote on that?
No, we don't.
Vote on that.
We don't vote on that as we discussed a month ago.
Okay. 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 So, questions before we call the roll? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Ordinance 11-23, please.
Ordinance 11-23 is to amend Section 90-515 of the Code of Ordinances by adding subsection 140 to rezone 2929 Burlingame Avenue Southwest from B2 local business to form-based code corridor suburban. This ordinance is in final reading.
Motion, please. Postma, support by Arnoyes. Cole's not here, but she went over it pretty good, I think, at the last meeting. But give us, again, a little overview. And just a reminder that we're voting on this change of zoning tonight, the rezone. We're not really voting on approval of any specific project or buildings on that site, correct?
Correct. This is to rezone it from B2 local business to form-based code corridor suburban. The use is already allowed. They're looking for multifamily housing, including supportive housing. But the current zoning has a 35-foot building height limit. And I think one or maybe both of the buildings they're looking at putting up there would exceed that. I think they're looking at a four-story building. So by rezoning it to the form-based code corridor suburban, it would allow that height and that use, which is already allowed by the current.
You probably recall the discussion of this last month, but any questions? It's the Cherry Health Clinic. I decided their property there. Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Postma?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. That ends our business items tonight. Any informational material, Mr. Shea?
Nope, that's tonight.
Acknowledgement of visitors. This public comment period is an opportunity to share concerns or present topics to the City Council that were not part of this meeting's agenda. This is not an opportunity for dialogue with Council, but Council may make referrals or request staff to follow up. Please provide your name and address when approaching the podium. There's a 3-minute limit per person. Public comment tonight? Mr. Anderson,
My name is Derek Anderson on Blandford in Wyoming. Good evening, council members and everybody. Last time I had the opportunity to speak up here, I wanted to encourage you to think and act and govern boldly as it pertains to righteousness and in our community here. I wanted to do a similar thing tonight as well, to encourage and to motivate you to take a stand for righteousness in our city. And so to do that, I wanted to read a few verses to you here from Ezekiel chapter 22. I'll start in verse 17, skip down a little bit, and then continue on. Ezekiel 22 says that, "And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, the house of Israel," who's referring to the nation of Israel at that time, "has become dross to me. They are all of them are bronze and tin and iron and lead in the furnace. They are the dross of silver." Basically saying the whole country has become impure. Boy, we look around and we see a lot of that, don't we? I'm going to skip down, starting again in verse 25 now. He says, "There's a conspiracy of her prophets in her midst, like a roaring lion tearing the prey. They have devoured lives. They have taken treasure and precious things. They have made many widows in the midst of her." So he has an indictment against some of the religious people of that time, the prophets, who were acting contrary to God's law. He goes on, he says, "Her priests," so again, more indictment against some of the religious leaders of the time, "her priests have done violence to my law and profaned my holy things. They have made no distinction between the holy and profane. They have not taught the difference between the clean and the unclean, and they hide their eyes from my Sabbaths, and I am profaned among them." So more indictment against some of the religious leaders. "Her princes," now the political leaders within her, "are like wolves tearing the prey by shedding blood and destroying lives in order to get dishonest gain. Her prophets have smeared whitewash for them," the political leaders. So we saw this in our city when many of the churches here in town sided with the tyrants during the whole COVID fiasco, when they were forcing their congregants to get vaccinated or to wear masks, things contrary to God's law. So he says he has an indictment against all these people in leadership, and then he comes to the people, and he said, "The people of the land have practiced oppression and committed robbery. They have wronged the poor and needy and have oppressed the sojourner without justice." And if you were to ask our public safety personnel, they interact with this every day. The people of our community are also corrupt. We're all sinners. We all fall short of the glory of God. So what should we do? God says this, "I searched for a man among them who would build up the wall and stand in the gap before me in the land so that I would not destroy it. But I found no one. Thus I have poured out my indignation upon them, and I have consumed them in my fire of my wrath. Their way I have brought upon their heads, declares the Lord." My last 10 seconds, I want to encourage you to be the men and to be the women who build up the wall, who stand in the gap, who proclaim righteousness, and to stand for what is good, true, and beautiful in our city. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. Anybody else out there? Public comment, this is your chance. Okay, we'll go around the council, starting with Mr. Postman.
I have nothing.
Mr. Brand?
Well, I know Catherine Corriers, who's been a really advocate for the fire department. She's really happy, John, with the questions you answered. Thank you for doing such a great job on that. And I just want to thank Catherine for her advocacy for the fire department. So, and then on the COVID thing, we lost 1 million people in this country because of COVID. I was state rep, and I did come out for a mask mandate. So it's a real thing. I lost a lot of friends on COVID. So I think sometimes that's a Christian way too, to try to save lives. So I just want to talk about that a little bit too.
Okay, thank you, Tom. Marissa, anything?
Yeah, I just realized I don't think we've had a meeting where we got to talk since the Concerts in the Park ended. This was our first season that was, run by the Wyoming Parks and Rec Department. So I just wanted to shout them out. I thought it went really well, the one concert that I was able to attend, because I was gone for most of the summer. But I thought it was awesome. I was really happy to see a good turnout. And now that we've taken over, there's a lot more, I guess, little stuff going on with that. The bookmobile was there, KDL, so... Yeah, just thank you
summer.
To the Parks Department.
It's a good summer. You missed it. So did I. Rob?
I have nothing. Thank you.
Robert?
Nothing tonight.
Today?
Not that I can think of right now.
Okay. I wanted to echo what Marissa said. By the way, you read our last meeting, but I forgot to do around the council. It was an interesting summer. We had the rain out, then we had a concert, then we had a
fog out.
A fog out.
Yes.
And then we had a concert and stuff. So, but it you know, from every report we got, it was really, really good. You got a report on Metro Cruise, I believe, last time. Got that last week, didn't we?
No, well,
where did I get a report on Metro Cruise?
We'll be providing, we're going to have an internal meeting, kind of an after action report, if you will, to discuss Metro.
Maybe it was just me talking with you and staff and that. We will be bringing an after action report on Metro Cruise back. I heard good positive things. Again, I was out of town. I had a funeral on the east side of the state, so I could not attend. Kids are back in school. Obviously, that changes our daily life pattern for a lot of us. I'm a grandpa now. I'm still a parent, but a grandpa, so it doesn't affect me as much as many of our families out there. So, with that, we'll just adjourn the meeting, and we will be back here on September 18th.